In this video, revealing how to quit your job with dividend investing so you never have to work ever again for the rest of your life. More with that after the intro. Hey guys, how's it going? Mike Vasile here. Welcome to this video. Before we actually begin, I remind you that HubSpot have opened up for this week's free workshop, where it's the fastest and easiest way to make money online. Sign up for it in the link below. We literally have a 62-year-old woman go from zero to 160 grand profit in 90 days, so sign up for it now. So I remember I had a wealthy uncle earlier on in life, and I was just amazed on the fact that I never saw him working. Like every single year when we would go ahead and, for example, visit them in Texas, he was always just hanging out, barbecuing, playing with the dogs, and hanging out with his kids. And I was just curious on how he doesn't work and how he retired a lot earlier than most other people around me. Like in my mind, I thought, oh, to retire, you have to work a job and wait till you're 65 and then you could never have to work ever again for the rest of your life. And that was like the mental model that like was played into my life. But I literally saw him, not literally old, right? I think he was like in his like late 40s and he just stopped working. Right? So it made me start wondering, how the heck did he do this? And I started asking him, and this was kind of like my first, throw into the finance and investment world and like retirement vehicle worlds, because I didn't know that didn't existed, was he said, Mike, you know, when I was younger, I just had extra money and I just kept on throwing it in AT&T, which actually is a dividend stock that gives out a dividend yield. And you know, now all the dividends that come to me every single like, you know, quarter or year or whatever, like company does it, because it comes in different times, I just never have to work ever again for the rest of my life. And I didn't really understand that until later on when I started making money and I needed to find out where I could actually go out and invest it, right? And you could actually see exactly what it is. So currently it yields about like 7.4% for the AT&T stock that he ended up getting. Current share price at this time is this. And it has an annualized dividend payment of $1 per stock that you actually own. So it'll end up owning, like yielding about 4.2%, right, on average, right? So you literally gotta do the math, right? Like if you own this stock and you know you get like, for example, a 4% dividend yield, you don't necessarily get it, like for example, he didn't really care on what price that he got it, because he got it like decades ago, right? So like you could make a bunch of money as, you know, the stock increases in price, but what he literally, for example, retires on is the dividend yield that he gets paid for just owning the stock, right? Where essentially, because you own a stock like AT&T or whatever like other stock that actually owns and pays off dividends, which you can see is Procter & Gamble, Coca-Cola, you have Realty Income, you have Johnson & Johnson, you even have Target, you have Verizon, Microsoft, Apple, Welltower, all of these like very popular brands, they pay off in dividend. In this case, in my uncle's case, he just chose with, you know, for example, AT&T. And why is that? Well, if you're able to get like a 4% in your dividend yield, that's like you just finding out a way of like never have to work ever again just by doing some math. So for example, I literally live here in Bali, right? Here in Bali is amazing because you have a lot of wealthy people that don't want to pay wealthy prices, right? So this 11-year-old girl that I interviewed on my podcast that turned on $30 million, this guy that makes $1 million per month profit, but like doesn't spend that much, right? And for example, for me, even though I make really good money online from my multiple businesses, like this one that went from zero to 8 grand in 30 days, this one that went from zero to 6 grand in 30 days, so 1.6 million that first year with 30% profit margins, as well as this one, which we pull in 35 grand to 46 grand with my digital real estate business, right? My only, for example, expenses on a monthly basis, and this is me, like pushing it, is $2,000 to $3,000 a month. When before, actually, like it was actually a lot lower, which is only $700 a month, right? But assuming you don't want to live like a monk, like what I do, let's just say like $2,000 to $3,000, right? Well, the math is very simple. If I, for example, spend $2,000 a month, that's about like, for example, you know, $24,000 a year that I would need to, for example, live off of, right? But assuming that this has a 4.2% dividend yield, the math is very simple. I just divide that by 0.042%. And this is literally all the money that you necessarily need in, for example, a dividend stock, where you would essentially get to cover your expenses and then get to the point where then you never have to actually quit, like you don't actually have to work a job ever again, right? So you could see that you don't actually need to make millions, right? Because for example, if you just like, you know, monk it out for, you know, like a decade or so, and you get at a point where you have half a million saved, you could get to that safety point where if 24 grand was coming in every single year, which you could see that it's even more advantageous. Like on dividends and income, he talks about how the $20,000 in annualized tax-advantaged qualified dividend income could be analogous to a $50,000 in annual gross tax-disadvantaged job. Why? Because of the tax savings, cost benefits of not having a job, and reduced demand for saving. And that's kind of safe growing passive dividend income will be a dividend stock portfolio of $500,000, which is what we literally went over, assuming a 4% yield on the portfolio, right? So you could exactly see the benefits of literally making 20 grand a year in passive income from dividends would actually beat a $50,000 a year job. Just even from like the tax advantage savings. Of course, like I'm not a financial advisor. This isn't financial advice. So the step-by-step way to then quit your job is getting to that first $500,000, not so that you could retire and never work ever again, but like what Rich Dad Poor Dad and Robert Kiyosaki talked about is they want to just get enough in their investments so that worst case scenario, if their future businesses fail, they have that safety net to fall back on. You know, and it allows you to actually, for example, do the things that you love and not worry about, you know, making money because of the fact that, oh, worst case scenario, you could literally get by with, you know, 20 to 24 grand every single year. And then you could like do something crazy. Like for example, I ended up moving to Asia where the cost of living here is a lot lower. Like this nice place that's literally just, you know, 3 minutes away from the beach cost me like $700 a month. So you can see that, you know, we're living a good life, but we're also not like by any means struggling as we're saving a lot. And we can technically live off this dividend income. Like I said, this isn't financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor. So let's talk about the steps to actually get there. The first thing that you got to realize if you want to get that, if 500 grand is your goal, then the equation breaks down very, very simple. And the first step is just spending less, right? So for example, you know, like the only way you could invest is finding out, you know, how much you spend and decreasing it and making more money and investing the difference. That investing the difference is literally what my uncle did to put at least $500,000 into AT&T so that he never had to work ever again for the rest of his life, right? Let's actually break it down. So for example, I have a friend who makes $3,000 a month. He lives at home with his parents, and he still has no money left at the end of the day. And I remember when we were gonna start a business back when I lived in the States, I was like, dude, we both need to put in 500 bucks. And he's like, well, I don't have that money. And I'm like, why? Dude, you make $3,000 a month. Like, where is it going? You live at home with your parents. And when he tracked his expenses, he found out that he was spending a lot of money on like going out to the bars, on Chipotle, and a bunch of unnecessary purchases, like TVs and shoes and whatnot. And the moment he tracked it, he was like, okay, I gotta find a way to decrease how much I spend. And that's what anybody really needs to do. You know, I've done weird things to, for example, like save money. Like for example, when I went and did this crazy business right here that scaled like crazy, even when it scaled in that first couple of months, for the first like 6 months, I lived at home with my parents. Why? Because I was very stingy and I didn't know how long this was gonna last. So I was like, I need to cut my costs like as low as possible and live and mooch off my parents while I just like stack cash and save money. Like, does that make sense? The second step that you need to do once you find a way to decrease your like living expenses is find a way to increase how much you make. So if you have a job, the best thing that you could do is literally download the free 77 cheat sheet guide, which literally free 77 guides on exactly how to make money in so many various ways. So you could choose one that aligns with your personality and depending on how much time that you, for example, need. Like some of these only require like 30 minutes a day to go ahead and do. One of the easiest side hustles that you could get started with, which one of the first ways that I started making $100 a day, is just simply copy and pasting pictures on Walmart and just throwing them up on eBay, right? Because you can see, look at this, 12 have been sold, $268, but you could see the same exact product as this on Walmart for less. So I would just arbitrage the difference and pocket the profit and start stacking cash that way. Even if you just did that on the side with a job and started spending less and increased your earning potential, you could already start putting enough money out on the side. And the last but not least step is just being patient. And this is a long-term game. Like you're not gonna make, for example, 500 grand like overnight, right? This literally takes time and it takes a lot of patience. And the most patient thing that you could do is just sticking to the plan for the next 10 years and just keeping it very, very, very boning. And if you like being more risky, then you can maybe start your own online business, right? But that's essentially it. Remember, this is financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor, but what I'm actually doing is a little bit different and a little bit more simple, right? Essentially what I do is I start online businesses, which if you need help, there's 77 free guides in the link below. And you can see we do really well with these. The next step that I do is I, for example, follow this book, right? which this book essentially, you know, demystifies all the things that you need to do with your finances, where I need to save money for taxes, for my operation costs, for my business, as well as for my future investments, right? And then all I really do is I automate it. Very simple. I don't do dividend paying stocks. I literally follow this book, which is A Simple Plan of Wealth, which is essentially investing in index funds like Vanguard's VTSAX, which they also pay off with dividend as well. And you can see their average dividend yield is about like 1% or so, but also like the stock grows as well, right? And the reason why I keep it simple and why these two books were literally like my Bibles is one will give me the discussing abnormal returns, which is my business because I could control it. And because it's my core competency, I know if I focus in on that, I could consistently beat the market because it's like my baby, right? And I understand my business very, very well. On the other hand of things, you know, I also want to get to the point where I don't have to worry about a business to, for example, live off of my dividends, which essentially comes into this, which is literally the simplest plan to wealth, because the only downside with this is assuming AT&T stays in business, right? Which most businesses don't survive 50 years or even 100 years. So how will I know when I retire that this still will exist? Which is why like I'm more afraid of just throwing all of like my money in one specific dividend stock, like what my uncle did. I like it being a little bit more safe because VTSAX essentially is investing in like 2,000 or 3,000 companies at the time, depending on whatever year that you're looking at this. And it's like the top stocks. Like, so you invest in like Warren Buffett's Berkshire Hathaway, Apple, Google, Netflix, Johnson & Johnson, all these other, you know, stocks that pay dividends, Coca-Cola, they're all like, for example, in VTSAX, right? And that's really it. That's what I do. I keep it simple, guys. But if you want an even faster and easier way to make money in line, to go ahead and fund this, like for example, dream of making enough money, that 500 grand right here so that you never have to work ever again for the rest of your life, then sign up for this week's free workshop below, because we literally talk to this to people all around the world, from Thailand to Bali to Las Vegas, on the fastest way to go from zero to $1,000 a day and how to save that money, invest the difference so that they never have to work ever again for the rest of their life. Again, remember, this isn't financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor. But if you want to get inspired, check out my podcast, because there's really successful people that live here in Bali. Like this 11-year-old girl that turned on $30 million, and this guy makes $1 million per month profit. Check it out right here. Hopefully this helps. Love you guys. See you guys later. Woo!